大数据时代，科技 data 在这场新冠肺炎抗疫战当中扮演了什么角色？
Online applications and social networking have been crucial. To encourage ongoing public participation in the battle against the coronavirus, every day South Korean health authorities send text messages to everyone's smartphones. The advisories remind people to avoid large groups, practice 2-meter safe distancing, and regularly disinfect their homes, leaving the windows open. South Korean health authorities' emergency alerts share the locations of new coronavirus patients. People can then follow the links to detailed patient tracking data. Web developers like Ryan Junso Hong have collected and aggregated that information to more user-friendly websites.
That's in the text format. So even if you read that place name, you don't really know where exactly it's located. So I tried to plot that out on the map so that people can efficiently see where it's exactly located so that they know if they've been to that place.
Contact tracing is one of the hottest keywords in South Korea at the moment. It tracks the history, timeline, and the locations visited of a coronavirus patient. Amid the fast-spreading coronavirus outbreak, information such as the restaurant and hotel the confirmed patient went to, how they had arrived, which subway line or the number of the bus they took is shown. Even the seat they had sat in at the movie theater is being revealed.
韩国的防疫策略，一个月压平每日新增病例曲线的经验给出了答案。借助手机科技和网络大数据资料库，将新冠病毒确诊感染者与病毒潜伏期间的移动路径，从去过的场所、搭过的巴士、地铁，甚至是电影院里的座位号码，事物大小全部找出来。卫生当局以此作为基础，拉开了防疫网。找出感染的源头，也搜寻全部的可能接触者。同时，这些资讯会以即时简讯的方式传送到每一位民众的手机里。而疫情通报 App 再将这些文字讯息整合成为地图，就可以让民众随时方便检视自己是不是处在这些危险区域的范围内。全力追踪感染者和接触者，完全公开其移动路径资讯的示警做法，是2015年 MERS 疫情当中学习来的宝贵一课。韩国政府和总部位于加拿大的 AI 公司进行合作，利用资讯科技手段来追踪及监控感染的扩散。韩国国会还为此通过修法，让政府能够获得授权，当传染病爆发，国民健康受到威胁的时候，就可以采取非常手段取得个人信息资料。最终目的是要让病毒的扩散无所遁形。
Tracing through surveillance technology played a very big part in this fight against the coronavirus. If the country has very big capacity of testing, if you don't know who to test, the testing capacity has only limited use. So to find out who to test, surveillance technology was really helpful.
Well, nowadays, practically all of us leave a kind of trail of digital breadcrumbs behind us as we move through our lives. If you have GPS or Bluetooth turned on your phone, for instance, then that can provide pretty specific information as to your whereabouts or who you might have come close to. Other information that can be used is, for example, when or where you might have made purchases with a bank card,or a credit card, and then of course in places that are directly monitored via CCTV, you can employ facial recognition technology to pretty precisely determine exactly when someone was where. In South Korea, which has so far had some of the greatest success at containing the virus, without resorting to draconian measures like lockdowns, tracking the previous movement of people who tested positive has relied on a combination of all those measures.
手机科技也被用来作为管控隔离者的手段。居家隔离者还有入境韩国的旅客都被要求下载一款 App， 每日两次要上传体温等自我健康管理数据。而防疫人员则是借由这款 App 定位相关人员的位置进行监控。如果擅自离开隔离定点，防疫单位会立刻收到 App 的自动回报。如果没有定时上传自我管理数据，也会马上接到电话关切。数位科技的运用，正是早期疫情获得有效管控，疫情升高之后也没有实施封城的重要关键。
In Asia, there is just more acceptance. Public health trumps privacy, which you surrender in return for greater protection from a killer virus. And this is a trade-off which most people support. Personal data harvested from debit cards and mobile phones being crunched by government apps which enable better, more detailed contact tracing, the creation of travel histories, and even alert users if they get too close to where an infected person's been.
I think it is a balancing act. Korean response was quite draconian if you compare it to the standards that you might think in UK. So, but it was not as drastic as what they have done in China. So I think you have to really see the balance between how we can sacrifice in terms of privacy, but also how we can really work for the common good of the public.
尽管西方防疫专家肯定韩国所采用的数位科技追踪手段确实有效控制了病毒扩散，但手机定位、信用卡的记录都涉及了个人隐私问题。对追求自由和注重隐私保护的西方，想要完全复制这么一种侵入性的追踪防疫手段，可能并不容易。